I'm going to show you how to make a cinematic title flip animation using PowerDirector. Let's flip the freak out. I'm going to start off by going up to the title room. And under all content, you should see a default title. I'm going to hold down my left mouse button and I'm going to drag it down to track one. Now I want to change the duration of the title. So I'm going to click on the duration button. I don't want it to be a little bit shorter than the default, so I'm going to change it to 3 seconds. Now I'm going to double left click on the title to open up the title designer. I'm going to double left click in the text box to select it. I'm going to go to the font and I'm going to change it to Poppins Medium. I'm going to change the font size to 88. And I'm going to change the line spacing to 18. And I want to make the text bold. And I want to make it italicized. And then I'm going to type in the text that I want it to say. Now I need to get this centered where I want it on the screen. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the TV safe zone and grid lines. I'm going to left click on that. I'm going to go to grid lines and I'm going to choose 3x3. Now I'm going to go to align objects and I want to go to horizontal center. Go to align objects again. And I'm going to go to vertical center. Now it's not inside the grid lines where I want it. So I'm going to place my cursor over this line until I see crosshairs. I'm going to left click on it once. And then I'm going to use my arrow keys to move the text up to the position I want it in. So now I want to add a detached border to this text. So I'm going to go up here to add a new title. And I'm going to type in the same text that I had before. I'm going to click on border. And I'm going to uncheck font face. Then I'm going to open up the border settings. I'm going to change the size of the border to 1. And I'm going to change the border color to white. And now I'm going to go ahead and close up the border settings. And I'm going to go down to object settings. It's not open and you can just click on it to open that up. I'm going to change the scale. Because I want it to be a little bit larger than the text. And then I'm going to go ahead and drag this into position. You can just place your cursor over to see the crosshairs. Hold on your left mouse button. And you can drag this over and up. Also, if you already know the parameters, you can type them in. You can use your arrow keys to move the text where you want it to be. All of that good stuff. Once you get it in a position, you can go ahead and click on OK and close it out. Now we need to go ahead and duplicate the text so that we can add our other words. So we're going to right click the title. We're going to select copy. We're going to hit the end key on our keyboard so that our playhead goes to the end. We're going to right click on the track and we're going to select paste. Then we're going to click the end key on our keyboard again. We'll right click on the end and select paste. And now we have the text on here 3 times. So we need to change the word so that it's not the same word over and over again. So we're going to double left click on the second title. And we're going to change the text to flip. Or whatever word you want it to be. We're going to go to align objects. And we're going to go to horizontal center. Then we'll go to the other text that we created, the font face. We'll left click on that. Change the text. Go to align objects and horizontal center. Should line up. Click on okay. And we'll go to the last text, double left clicked on that to open up the title designer. Change it to the next word. Go to align objects, horizontal center. We'll go to the next title, left click on it. Change the word so that it matches up. Go to align objects, horizontal center. And we'll click on OK. Now we need to go ahead and make the word flip into the new word. So we're going to use a transition for that. So we'll go up to the transition room. And then we're going to go down to the spin transition. And we're going to use the spin horizontal. Hold on our left mouse button. We're going to drag it down to the beginning of the first clip. And then we'll go ahead and drag it down in between the second and first clip and the second and third clip. And then we'll drag one more time down to the end of the third clip. Another cool trick you can do is make your title appear from behind an object, which I show you how to do in this tutorial. Don't forget to smash my face to subscribe. Hit me up with your comments and drop me a like down below.